Welcome to Zearn. In this video, we'll show educators how to use data from their class reports to support their students as they implement Zearn Math. As you get started with Zearn in your classroom, you'll want to look at these three important data points. Are students signing in regularly? Are students completing at least three lessons a week? And lastly, as you see how students respond to the just-in-time supports within each lesson, where do students need celebration or extra support? You'll find these data points in your class reports. To get there, go to the Reports tab and look under Class Reports. Zearn works differently in kindergarten than it does in grades 1-8, and Zearn reports reflect that design. In this video, we'll talk about grades 1-8. As you get started with Zearn, the first thing to look for in your data is that all students are signing into Zearn regularly. To see student sign-ins for grades 1-8, you'll use the PACE report, which shows you how students are progressing through digital lessons each week. Go to the Reports tab and select PACE report under Class Reports. The top of the PACE report shows the class lesson completion for the last 4 weeks. The table underneath shows the activity for each of your students by week. To see when each student last signed in, look at the last login on the far right. Clicking the column heading will sort students by their most recent login. This will let you identify any students who may not have signed in recently and could use a check-in. Once students are signing in consistently, the next data point to check is whether they are completing at least three grade level lessons a week on Zearn. Our recent research shows that students who completed three or more grade level lessons a week on Zearn, which usually takes about 90 minutes, experienced 2 to 3 times the growth of their peers. You can see students' lesson completion in the PACE report by looking at the grades 1-8 lessons. This shows you the total number of lessons students completed each week across the last 4 weeks. Students who completed three or more lessons in a week are colored in green. It's also important to know if the lessons students are completing are aligned to their grade level. We encourage teachers to begin students on grade level content, allowing the digital lessons to automatically launch just-in-time support as students need it. Of course, students' learning needs will vary, and assigning prior grade level lessons is sometimes helpful. With this in mind, you can use the filter by grade tool to show only the grade level lessons that were completed. Select your grade from the dropdown to confirm that the majority of the content students are completing is on grade level. If students aren't completing at least three grade level lessons each week, the first thing to check is whether or not they're getting enough time on Zearn. Scroll up to the classroom summary chart. Click on a group completing 2 or fewer lessons to see how much time they spent on Zearn that week. If students are learning for at least 90 minutes on Zearn, but still aren't completing 3 lessons a week, they may be struggling unproductively with the content, which brings us to our next data point. The third data point to look for is where students might benefit from celebration and extra support. To do that, you'll look at the Tower Alerts report. Go to the Reports tab and click on the Tower Alerts report. At the end of each digital lesson is a formative assessment called the Tower of Power. When a student struggles in the Tower of Power, Zearn provides them with a boost of just-in-time support. When they struggle repeatedly with the same big idea, even after receiving boosts, it creates an alert, which is captured in this report. Each alert names the student and the lesson. It shows how many times the student struggled, and whether they completed the lesson and moved on, or if they're still stuck. You can see instances of productive struggle reflected in these alerts. For example, in this alert, the student struggled repeatedly and received support from Zearn, but was then able to work through the tower and complete it independently. Celebrating when students persevere can reinforce their understanding that making mistakes is part of how we learn. You can also filter alerts to help find students who may be struggling unproductively. Hiding completed towers will show which students were unable to complete the lesson and move forward. Changing the date range can show you where your support may be the most timely. And increasing the number of struggles can help you see which students may be most in need of support. Checking the Tower Alert report throughout the week can help you monitor student struggle in order to celebrate and intervene at just the right times. A few final notes on reports. Sometimes reports can look off if rosters are inaccurate, so always check your roster before digging into your reports. You can do this by going to the Roster tab and reviewing your student list. If your student roster isn't correct, contact your school or district IT team. If you need any additional assistance, just contact us directly at schoolaccounts@zearn.org. We've touched on the PACE and Tower Alerts reports. For a more detailed walkthrough of these and other class reports, just click on the Class Reports heading in the Reports tab. Finally, as your class works towards completing 3 grade level lessons a week, know that students can also monitor their own progress towards that goal. On the student homepage, students have a calendar button in the upper left. Clicking the calendar button shows them a week-by-week view of the lessons they've completed. The shaded days show when they signed into Zearn. The badges show when they completed lessons. This enables them to reflect on their progress and take an active role in working towards their lesson completion goals. To summarize, as you get started with Zearn in your classroom, you'll use the PACE and Tower Alerts reports to look for each of the following data points. First, ensure that all students are signing in regularly. Next, make sure students are completing 3 or more grade level lessons each week. Finally, monitor student struggle to provide timely instructional support and encouragement. And with that, you're ready to use the class reports to support your students as they get started with Zearn. To learn more, join our hashtag MathFam by connecting with Zearn on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook for ongoing ideas and inspiration from teachers.